You know, people need to take ownership of their criminal justice system. They're citizens. You know, they decide whether to re-elect a prosecutor, and they should know what goes on in the courts. They decide whether to re-elect judges. It's hard for them because they don't know. They're not down there and they see what happens. But they should ask around, talk to prosecutors, talk to defense attorneys, talk to people who have had experience with elected officials in our courts, and make a rational, reasoned judgment about whether they belong in the positions of power that they have. Don't just vote for them because they're in one party or not, or another, you know. Go beyond that. And when you get a jury summons in the mail, everybody tries to get out of their jury duty. You know, that's the first thing people think of. Oh, I don't want to do this. And, you know, they should realize that it's a very important civic duty, and that they should take the opportunity to serve as jurors if they're picked and selected. And that when they do, they have to, you know, obey the law, and they have to really hold the state to its burden of proof beyond a reasonable doubt, and make sure that the defendant is presumed innocent by them. And that when they get into a jury room, if they do, that they're entitled to their own opinion, and they're entitled to keep that opinion, even if the other jurors are trying to dissuade them or even intimidate them to change their verdict. They don't have to. They're individuals. So those are some takeaway lessons I hope people take.
Some of my best friends like Star Wars, don't get me wrong. But Star Wars has magic in it. You know, it has the Force, and it's really about family conflicts, and it's Shakespearean. It's this nobility, essentially.